Hi guys, welcome again to Sunil Engineering Academy YouTube channel, and this is Srinivas. In this video, we are going to discuss about the IBPS, Institute of Banking Personnel Selection, popularly known as IBPS, has released its notification for regional rural banks seeking POs and clerks. IBPS has recently released its 2020 and this year's notification for seeking requirements of officers scale 1, 2 and 3 and office assistants multi-purpose in regional rural banks all over our India. Okay, let's move to the details of the notification. First of all, the number of vacancies. This is what we all look at the notification. When the notification comes out, first of all, we look at the what are the vacancies. Here is the vacancies, number of vacancies. IBPS RRB, office assistant, multi-purpose, popularly known as clerk. There are 4,682 vacancies. 4,682 vacancies, and much of vacancies. And IBPS RRB, officer, scale 1, there are 3,800 vacancies. And for scale 2 agriculture officers, there are 100 vacancies. For scale 2 marketing officer, there are 8 vacancies. For treasury officer, there are 3. For law officer, there are 26. For scale 2 CA, there are 26. For IT officer, there are 59. And for general banking, there are 838 vacancies. And officer scale 3, for officer scale 3, there are vacancies of 156. If you take the total number of vacancies in this notification, it is 9,698. Very good vacancies. Handful of vacancies for those who are preparing seriously for the notification. And you look, and if you look at the last year vacancies, there were 8,354. That means 8,354 vacancies were filled by the IBPS RRB in the previous notification. But this time, we can say that there is an incredible increase in the number of vacancies. If you talk about the age is the very important point. Age is the very important point for any of us when a new notification comes in. Then what is the age requirement? For officer scale 3, that is senior manager, the candidate who is seeking a requirement of senior manager in RRB scale 3, he should be about 21 years and below 40 years. That means he should not be born earlier than the 3rd of July 1980 and later than 30th of June 1999, both date inclusive. For officer scale 2, it is 21 years, he should be above 21 years and below 32 years. And for office assistant manager, that means officer scale 1, assistant manager, the age is above 18 years and below 30 years. We should be above 18 years and we should be below 30 years. Below 30 years, and the cutoff date is here. Cutoff date is here. For office assistant, that means popularly known as clerk, we should be above 18 years and should not cross 28 years. That means a person who is seeking an opportunity as a clerk should not be born earlier than 2nd of July 1992 and should not born later the 1st of July 2002. Both days inclusive. But there are some age relaxations for different categories. If a person is a scheduled caste or scheduled tribe person, then the person will get 5 years of relaxation for any of the post discussed above. 5 years of relaxation. If a person belongs to other backward classes, that means OBCs, other backward classes, OBCs, then a person is entitled to get 3 years of age relaxation. If a person with benchmark disability, can get 10 years of relaxation in terms of age. This is the age prescribed. If you talk about the educational qualification and experience, For office assistant multipurpose, that is clerk, we should possess a bachelor degree in any discipline from a recognized university. We should possess a bachelor degree. And we should have a proficiency in the local language as prescribed by the participating RRBs. We should have some knowledge about the local language to which region you are applying for. We need to get the local language proficiency. And the desirable qualification is working knowledge of computers. This is only the desirable qualification, not mandatory, but a desirable qualification only. Remember, this is not mandatory. For officer scale 1, that means assistant manager, the same, there is no change for educational qualification in terms of bachelor degree. We can have any bachelor degree from any discipline, but the preference will be given to candidates having degrees in agriculture, horticulture, forestry, animal husbandry, and etc. according to the field or the post they are applying for. It may varies. For officer scale 2, that is general banking officer, or popularly known as manager, the same bachelor degree is required, and the preference will be given to those candidates who are, but here the minimum marks of 50% marks in aggregate is required. For the categories of clerk and officer scale 1, there is no mandatory of percentage of marks, but for officer scale 2, there is a mandatory of 50% aggregate marks in the bachelor degree. Okay, and experience 2 years as an officer in a bank or financial institution. A person seeking the post of officer scale 2, that is general banking manager, should possess 2 years of experience as an officer in a bank or financial institution. If you talk about the chartered accountants or MBA for the financial officer, and then for marketing officer, MBA in marketing from a recognized university. A person who is seeking marketing officer should possess an MBA degree with 1 year in relevant field. For agriculture officer, he should possess agriculture, horticulture, or dairy, or animal husbandry, etc., a bachelor degree from those fields, bachelor degree from those streams, with a minimum of 50% marks in aggregate, and he should possess the 2 years experience in that field, relevant field. For officer scale 3, a bachelor degree with 50% aggregate, again, a 50% aggregate is required, and a preference will be given to those candidates belong to some categories given here, the agriculture, horticulture, forestry, and animal husbandry, and etc. And the experience, a minimum 5 years of experience as an officer in a bank or financial institution. He should possess a minimum of 5 years of experience as an officer in a bank or financial institution for applying officer scale 3, that is senior manager. Okay. If we talk about the dates, the most important thing, the dates, the online registration, that means the applying of application is starting from the 1st of July 2020, and it can be apply up to 21st of July 2020. Remember the dates. The application starts on the 1st of the July this month, this year, and it is going to be end on 21st of July this month and this year. And payment of application fee or intimation charges is as same as the date of the application. And downloading of call letters for preliminary exam training. If you are applying for the preliminary exam training, then you are going to download the call letters for preliminary exam training on 12th of August 2020, and conduct of preliminary exam training can be tentatively from 24th of August 2020 to 29th of August 2020. And you can download the call letters for preliminary examination in August 2020. And the online examination of preliminary is going to be conducted tentatively on September or October. Remember, these dates are tentative only. They may vary. There may be a change. There may be a change if RRBs are decided. And result of online examination of preliminary. The preliminary exam result will be released on October 2020. And then the online exam of main exam can be conducted in October or November 2020. Once again, remember these dates are just tentative dates and dates can be changed. It is the sole right of the IBPS. If you talk about the online examination structure, the preliminary examination for clerk, office assistant, that means clerk, there is a preliminary and mains examination for office assistant, that is clerk, and PO, that means probationary officer. If you talk about the preliminary examination of office assistant, there are only two sections in the preliminary examination. One is reasoning and another is numerical ability. And medium of examination, the star mark indicates that we can choose any of the languages that are allowed by the IBPS RRB, and that can be changes from place to place. If you are applying for Andhra Pradesh or Telangana, then you can choose Telugu, English or Hindi. Or if you are applying for Karnataka, then you can choose Kannada, Hindi or English. And that varies with the place where you are applying for. That means you can be able to attempt your exam in the regional language. Okay, this is a very good stuff for those candidates who completed their studies in the regional languages. And in the section of reasoning, there are 40 questions and the maximum marks are 40. That means 1 mark each for the question. And in numerical ability also, there are 40 number of questions and 40 marks. That means the preliminary examination is going to be for 80 questions for 80 marks. 80 questions for 80 marks. And the time duration, very important point, the time duration is a composite time of 45 minutes. That means the composite time means there is no sectional timing. There will be a 45 minutes of time you can use as you according to your wise. There is no sectional time cutoff for reasoning and numerical abilities. There is a composite time of 45 minutes. That means you have to attempt 80 questions within the time of 45 minutes. You should be very quick. Prepare for that. And for officer scale 1, the same officer scale 1, the preliminary examination is very same as the clerk. There is only two sections, reasoning and quantitative aptitude. Medium of examination is what I have discussed earlier. And the number of questions are also same. There are 40 reasoning questions for 40 marks and there are 40 numerical ability questions for quantitative aptitude. That means quantitative aptitude questions for 40 marks. A total of 80 questions for 80 marks and with a composite time of 45 minutes. Here also there is no sectional time cutoff for the reasoning and quantitative aptitude. You can use your time according to your wish. Within the 45 minutes. And if you talk about the main examination, after clearing the preliminary examination, we have to go to main examination. For office assistant, that means for clerk, there is a main examination. In that main examination, there are 5 sections. That means you can choose one of the sections of 4A or 4B. That means now we can say that there is only 4 sections. A reasoning, same as the regional languages as prescribed in the preliminary examination. A number of questions will be 40. And for the 50 marks, in the main examination of the clerk, reasoning, the 40 questions of reasoning are going to be give us the 50 marks. And then computer knowledge, there will be 40 questions for 20 marks. And for general awareness, there will be 40 questions for 40 marks. And English language or Hindi, you can choose any one of these. You can choose English language or you can choose Hindi language, English or Hindi. The number of questions for English will be 40 for 40 and or Hindi. If you choose Hindi, then you will be to write the 40 number of questions in Hindi with for 40 marks. And then numerical ability. Numerical ability, there will be 40 questions for 50 marks. The 40 questions of numerical ability are going to get 50 marks. A total of 200 questions for 200 marks. And time, the most important time, a composite time of 2 hours. Here again here there will be no sectional timeout. There will be no sectional time cutoff. A composite time of 2 hours is given. Very good move, very good move. Okay. If we talk about the main examination of PO, that means officer scale 1, the reasoning, the first section, that is reasoning, is going to be give us 50 marks out of 40 questions, and computer knowledge is going to give us 20 marks out of 40 knowledge, and general awareness 40 marks out of for 40 questions. You can choose English language or Hindi language, any one of the language, that is English or Hindi, for the fourth section. That is, for English there will be 40 questions for 40 marks. And then the quantitative aptitude, the most important section, that is quantitative aptitude, there will be 40 questions for 50 marks. And again for PO also there are 200 questions for 200 marks, and the composite time of 2 hours is given. For main examination of officer scale 1 also there is a composite time of 2 hours. That means we can use the 2 hours according to our wish. There is no sectional timeout in the main examination also. Okay, remember one thing, there is a composite time of 2 hours only. And here is the list of version of mediums. If you are applying for Andhra Pradesh, you can choose English, Hindi or Telugu. If you are applying for Gujarat, you can choose English, Hindi or Gujarati, and so on. You can search for the state which you are going to apply for. And then there will be a single level examination. There will be a single level examination for officer scale 2 and scale 3. There is a preliminary and main examination for clerk and PO, that is officer scale 1 and multi-purpose office assistant. But there is a single level examination only for officer scale 2, officer scale 3 and officer scale 3. Okay, officer scale 2, general banking officer, specialist cadre, or officer scale 3. If you are applying for scale 2 or scale 3, you are going to give only one stage examination, that is single stage examination, that is of objective type. And you can see the sections and the number of marks and number and the composite time here in the slide. And negative marking, yes, very important point, negative marking. There is a penalty for wrong answers in the preliminary, both preliminary and mains and single level examination also. There will be a penalty of wrong answers marked in the objective test for each question for which a wrong answer has been given by the candidate. 1/4 of the marks assigned to that question will be deducted as penalty. That means the negative marking is nothing but 1/4 of, there is a 1/4 of negative marking. That means for every 4 questions attempted by you, if you attempted that wrong, then you will get 1 penalty marks. For every wrong attempts, there will be a 1 mark penalty. Okay, be aware of that. There is a penalty of 1/4. There is a penalty, that means the negative marks of 1/4 of negative marks are there. And cutoff score. A cutoff score will be decided by the IBPS RRBs later on, after the conducting of examination. An interview. Interview is applicable only for the post of officer scale 1, 2 and 3. There is no interview for office assistant or clerk. There is no interview for office assistant or clerk, and interview is applicable for only those candidates who are applying for scale 1, scale 2 and scale 3. After clearing the main examination. And how to apply. The procedure of applying. The how to apply. We have to go to the website, that is www.ibps.in. I will provide you the direct application link in the description. Please go through the description and get the direct link to apply. You are just one click away from the application when you go through the description below the video. We need to log into www.ibps.in and then click here to apply online for CRP RRBs officer scale 1, 2 and 3, or click here to apply for online for CRP RRBs office assistant multi-purpose, and we need to open that tab to apply that. And before applying we should furnish photograph, signature, left thumb impression and handwritten declaration. Before applying, make sure that you got your scanned copies of photograph, signature, left thumb impression, handwritten declaration. The declaration, what has to be written in the declaration is given in the description box. Please check the description box below the video. Make sure that you got all the four important things before applying for those prescribed posts. And application fees for officer scale 1, 2 and 3, there is an application fees of 175 rupees for SC, ST or PWD candidates, and for all the other candidates of OBCs or unreserveds or etc., the fee is 850 rupees only. 850 rupees for office assistants multi-purpose, that means for clerks, there is a fee of 175 rupees for SC, STs, PWBD or ex-serviceman candidates, and there is a fees of 850 rupees for all the other candidates. Okay, please make a note of this. 175 rupees if a candidate belongs to SC, ST or PWBD, and 850 rupees for all the remaining category candidates. How to pay? We can make the payment through RuPay, Visa, MasterCards, MasterCard, credit cards or internet banking or any mode of online banking. There is no problem for payment. You can pay the fee on an online mode of any mode. The tentatives, once again, take a note of the tentative notes, tentative dates. Okay, please make a note of tentative dates. The online registration is going to be end on 21st of July 2020. Please make a note of this. Apply, hurry. You can get the application link with one click in the description box. Please go through that link and apply. Okay, prepare well. And for the numerical ability or quantitative aptitude sections of the preliminary and both preliminary and mains examination, you don't need to go anywhere. In our channel, we have already started a complete quantitative aptitude series, and please go through those videos and you will be very comfortable with the sections of quantitative aptitude. And for reasoning classes, we are going to start reasoning classes very soon. And you don't need to go anywhere. Just follow our Sunil Engineering Academy YouTube channel and be very comfortable in those sections when you are in examinations. Okay, please go through my videos and check those out. Thank you and prepare well. Let's meet in the another section.